This is going to be the second video about dividing a polynomial by a polynomial using algebraic long division. And what I want to do in this video is explain how to check your answer. So let's go back to the first problem I did in the previous video. The problem was 3x squared minus 5x minus 7, and that was divided by x minus 3. And the answer we came up with was 3x plus 4 plus 5 over x minus 3. The 5 was the remainder, and we used the divisor, or the denominator, as the denominator of the fraction at the end of this. So to check this, since division and multiplication are opposites, we're going to take the division problem and check the answer by using multiplication. So here's what we do. We take this divisor, x minus 3, and we're going to multiply that by the whole number part, the non-fractional part of the answer. So we're going to multiply that by 3x plus 4. And we'll get to the remainder in a second. So multiplying this, we multiply the first term times the first term. We're going to get 3x squared. We multiply the outside terms, so we have x times 4 is 4x. Multiplying the inside terms, negative 3 times 3 gives me a negative 9x. And multiplying the last terms, we have negative 3 times 4 is negative 12. And now I'm going to take that remainder. Remember, that's the numerator of the fraction that I have left. Take the remainder and add it to everything else. And now I'm going to combine my like terms. So I've got 3x squared plus 4x minus 9x. Well, plus 4 and minus 9 gives me a negative 5x. And I've also got a negative 12 and a positive 5. That's going to be a negative 7. And if everything was right, then this product here, 3x squared minus 5x minus 7, will be the same as my original numerator, 3x squared minus 5x minus 7. So that's a way to know that this answer is the correct answer. Let's look at the other problem we did on the last video. So in this one, we had 2x squared minus 10 divided by x plus 2. And the answer we got was 2x minus 4 minus the fraction 2 over x plus 2. So once again, I'm going to take this denominator, the x plus 2, and multiply that by the non-fraction part of my answer, so 2x minus 4. And whatever I get here, I can write this here, I'm going to combine that with my remainder, which was negative 2. So the first term times the first term is x times 2x. That gives me 2x squared. X times negative 4, my outside terms. That gives me a negative 4x. My inside terms are 2 and 2x, so that gives me a positive 4x. Then I've got 2 times negative 4 is negative 8, and the negative 2 remainder from my answer. Now I'm going to combine like terms. I'll have 2x squared, negative 4x, positive 4x. They cancel. Then I've got a negative 8 minus 2 is negative 10. And looking at the original problem, I find that the answer I just got, 2x squared minus 10, is the same as the numerator of my original problem. Okay, so reviewing what we did to check, you take the denominator of your original fraction, or the divisor, if you're thinking of this as a division problem, and you multiply that by the non-fraction part of your answer. So that's what we have here. And then you're going to combine that with your remainder. So whatever sign you have before the fraction and the numerator of that fraction. So here's where we've set it up. Then you carry out your multiplication. You're multiplying a polynomial times a polynomial. Make sure you include, after you're done with the multiplication, make sure you include that remainder. Combine all your like terms, and you should end up with the original numerator. Okay? So I hope this helps. Please check your answers whenever you can. Students lose a lot of points due to carelessness, and it's always nice when there's a way to check a problem. Okay, see you next time.